Arsenal Fan TV, Mo, bit of a dodgy first half, but second half, much better performance.
Bit of a dodgy evening in total, wasn't it? It was just, you know, at one point we don't even know if the game's even going to go ahead. But before we
have you ever seen a game? I cannot remember going to football and see a game that's been delayed for 1 hour.
No, never. And
one hour, never.
I'll be honest with you, I hate this competition. I hate the fact that we're in this competition. 20-odd years of Champions League football, never a delayed kickoff. The first Europa League game we're in, 1 hour delayed kickoff, man. This competition, honestly, I hate it already. But
you better get used to it, man, because we're in it.
And
if we're in it, we've got to try and win it.
We deserve to be in it as well. You know, I'm not trying to make out like we're too superior for it. We did nothing in the Champions League for a long, long time. We deserve to be here, but I still just hate being here. It's a dropout cup, so, you know. But, yeah, look, you know, any competition we're in, I want to win it. Yeah. Whether that's Community Shield or Carabao Cup, no matter how much of a joke the competition is, I want to win it. And I want to win this just like anything else. But for me, the real important one is the Premier League. If I could take one, it's just the Premier League. So forget anything else. But look, today I'm glad we finally did the business. But as I tweeted before the game, seeing as it's an hour delayed in the kickoff, can we make out like they're 60 minutes on the clock? Because I knew what to expect. We always do this. We always waste the first half. Second half, though, we came up and we actually did the business. But it was...
Do you reckon that delayed start and all the issues and that had an effect on the team, though? I mean, that can't be good for your preparation. You're prepared to start 8:05, which is even a little bit later than normal. Anyway, because these games normally kick off about 1:45. Well, Champions League games kick off about 1:45. And then a whole hour after, that can't be good for your preparation.
Yeah, I agree. Look, it's not going to help your preparation, but then we've seen enough times Arsenal have such a rubbish first half anyway. It was really no different to the norm. But yeah, I agree. It can't help your preparation. And also, if the Arsenal fans to be sitting in the dressing room listening to the noise coming from the stands and these Colm fans making so much noise, yeah, they must have been a little bit out of their comfort zone. But do you know what I'd have to say? One thing, when I saw the footage earlier of the Colm fans walking through London, thousands of them, and I'd heard it at that point as well, no arrests made as well. It looked like they were, obviously there's always going to be a few. I heard a few bottles thrown, a few flares and that sort of thing, but nothing serious. And I thought to myself, do you know what, respect to those guys who have come out in numbers to back their team. And today they played the system. I know it's not the right thing to do, but as a football fan, it's hard not to admire what they did today because they absolutely played the system and they made it a home game. And really, they shouldn't have had a chance against us and gone in at halftime 1-0 up. And that's in no part, you know, down to their fans as well. Their fans played a massive part and they contributed to a brilliant atmosphere in there today and tried to make it like a home team for their game. So, in a way, credit to their fans, because even though they were in and around us, you've said it as well, a lot of Arsenal fans have said it, there was no trouble in the ground. They were just... Very good fans.
Not yet. You still got to get home.
Yeah, no. true. Yeah, we'll see what they're like now that they've lost. But, you know, I just, you know, I'd love to be like that. I'd love for Arsenal to be like that. But as we all know, our club do us no favours. They offer us no support in ever trying to cultivate that sort of an atmosphere in our ground. And also, the other thing I just want to say about the club as well, it seems to me like, How can all these away fans today not only get tickets in the home end, but get tickets in the home end, but all very, very close to the away section? This was a coordinated, very calculated effort. This wasn't buying from touts outside the ground and you sit where you sit. That was a very, very like small minority. This was people who had really done this in a very clever way. And that's why I say credit to them, because they played the system. The only way I can see that they would have done this, they would have joined the Arsenal Red membership and thought, oh, it's €35 or whatever it is for them, and then they would have gone on, selected just how we would have to buy a ticket, and then just looked at the interactive seat map and bought it as close to the canteen, the way section. I never would have thought that fans would have done that. It didn't enter my mind. Obviously it did for them. So now it's for the club, for Arsenal, for the officials at the club to react and put in some controls where if you're going to do that, you can't buy tickets for the next game or for the next 2 weeks of games or whatever. Because Another set of opposition, you know, a bit more troublemaking rather than just here to support their team after over two decades of not being in European competition, could have kicked off big time. And also, it depends on the way the game goes, doesn't it? If it's a more important game rather than the first group game, if we go and get a last-minute winner, do you know what I mean? If the circumstances are different, that could have been very nasty. So now it's on the club to guarantee the safety of the home fans and make sure that can't happen again.
Nice one.
Alexis Sanchez, start him on Sunday. Simple as.
Cool.